So you guys have definitely been pioneers and kind of innovators in using the data and insights that you garner across brands. How do you use data to kind of inform creative?
You know, for us, it's like data is throughout. It's like one of those things where that gives us the roadmap for what we need to build, because it's an immediate sort of feedback loop that we get with our consumers. So we can look at it and say, this is what we have an opportunity to create based off of. But then once we put it in the market, we can see what people are responding to and say, hey, listen, this is something that's unique that we can sort of riff off of and go in that certain direction and build upon that. So it's always using that sort of immediate feedback loop in real time in terms of monitoring the data and then using those insights to sort of inform what we do create.
And you guys have been amazing at kind of thinking through with a portfolio of brands, you know, is there a common set of themes that you see that actually make branded content successful, or is it kind of different every single time?
It's definitely different, because at the end of the day, you want the product to come through, and you know, at the end of the day, that you're trying to get a brand message across, and depending on that brand and depending on that message and that ultimate goal for the client's business, it kind of depends. But at the end of the day, it's trying to be true and unique and authentic. I think at the end of the day, like, authenticity is that plays throughout, and that sort of transcends a lot of different things and means a lot of different things at the end of the day, but it has to be real. Yep. And it has to really create that sort of point of connection with the consumer in terms of what they're interested in and also just what they just personally as human beings want to respond to.
Yeah, totally. So you talk about authenticity, like we talk about a lot, because oftentimes brands use data, but then they throw a non-authentic experience out there. As you think about the consumer, like, how do you run that, you know, earned media, or how do you know that you actually have sparked a vein that's gonna really drive a forest fire?
You're going into it with best laid plans, but you have to be able to pivot, so you have to be flexible. And sometimes the answers that we find midstream, and yeah, to that point where we're doing a lot of content and we put a lot out there and we try to create our stuff so it's actually flexible enough so that if we do see something getting a lot of traction, we can sort of go in that direction and sort of build upon that. And then from our standpoint, you know, with paid media, that just then informs the opportunity for us to then escalate that even further and to push it in a direction where we have something that's truly successful. Let's build upon that, you know, and help, you know, garner additional viral reach using paid tactics. Earned is like, for us, it's the ultimate goal. You know, that's where we know we have something special, and that's what we're always trying to manage towards. But knowing that it's tough to get there. And, you know, for us, that is the goal for which and how we optimize off of. So it's about the fact of, like, okay, if we have something, we've created something that people want to share, then we, you know, we've kind of created something that people, you know, are uniquely responding to. And, you know, we were talking about the idea of it being a choice base. So if a person opts into it and they want to consume it on their own time, you know, then their attention span for what you're, you know, what you produce is that much higher and that much greater, and you have that captive audience to sort of get across and communicate your brand's value proposition, which is, so at the end of the day, that's our ultimate goal.
So when you look at creative in those first 48 hours of a new release, is it frenetic and frantic? Like, do you see, at what point in time do you feel like, hey, we should expect this content to really take off?
It's immediate. Well, that's a great thing. I mean, with scale, you know, you get a statistical significant read on something very early on, especially with social and social platforms. Like, that reach builds incrementally fast, and for us, we get that data and can activate off that very quickly. So it is pretty frenetic right out of the gate in that sense, that we try to, like, design content that goes across screens and build it so it's ubiquitous and allow the consumer to opt in to watch on their own sort of time, and we find that sort of creates, you know, greater resonance, because again, that individual self-selecting to say, I want to watch this at this particular time. I mean, we're in an on-demand sort of world these days, so for us, it's like, how do we design content around that sort of content-consuming behavior? And, you know, for us, it's, you know, trying to figure out and design it so it fits, you know, for those each particular screens, or for those that consumer journey, or like what their daily life cycle looks like across their day in terms of how they wake up with one device and transition from device to device throughout the day, and try to sort of build programs and platforms that either get distributed across that or complement each other throughout the day. Whereas if I'm doing something on TV, I can complement that with a digital component to that allows for the audience to sort of dig deeper in terms of the content and the brand campaign.